Here's your wrestling news for July 26, 2021. And your headlines for today include: Jeff Hardy reportedly tests positive for COVID-19. John Cena faces Roman Reigns at WWE House Show. Top AEW star recently spoke to Triple H. Braun Strowman teased as bare-knuckle boxing signee. Instagram removes Braun Strowman's WWE photo for being violent. Latest photo of Brock Lesnar goes viral yet again. CM Punk having fun with AEW signing report on social media. He just smiled. WCW legend on asking Tony Khan about Daniel Bryan joining AEW. WWE Raw star teases possible match against Becky Lynch. Eddie Guerrero trends on social media after fan says he was a B-plus player, and more. We are kicking off today with some sad news from Jeff Hardy, who's reportedly tested positive for COVID-19. Jeff had been scheduled to do a meet and greet after tonight's Raw at the Record Bar in Kansas City, but the venue has confirmed that the event has been postponed because of Jeff's positive test. The former WWE World Champion will now have to quarantine for 2 weeks and won't be appearing at any live events in that time. The Record Bar said that any tickets purchased for the event will be valid for whenever this meet and greet is rescheduled, but there's no word on when that'll be. Hardy last wrestled on this past Monday's Raw, where the controversial decision was made for him to defeat Karrion Kross, and now the NXT champion won't be able to get his revenge on the charismatic Enigma thanks to this unfortunate positive test. Hardy won't be around for the next couple of weeks, but fans can see plenty of John Cena, who's set to work a full-time schedule following his return at Money in the Bank. On July 24th, WWE held its first non-televised event in over a year, and Cena headlined the show, teaming with the Mysterios to defeat Universal Champion Roman Reigns and SmackDown Tag Team Champions The Usos. Near the end of the match, Cena hit the AA on the Tribal Chief and delivered another one to one of The Usos, winning the match for his team. This was a wild main event to say the least, but on screen, Roman Reigns has rejected Cena's SummerSlam challenge and has instead accepted Finn Balor as his next opponent instead. Despite this, Cena vs. Reigns is expected to headline SummerSlam and has reportedly been locked in. And if you include the six-man tag dark match after this Friday's SmackDown, the 16-time WWE World Champion has not won, but two victories over the Tribal Chief since returning. AEW news next is Cody Rhodes' company has proven to be a massive success ever since the former TNT champion left WWE in 2016. Feeling like he'd hit a proverbial glass ceiling, Rhodes left to establish himself out of Vince McMahon's promotion, but there's no hard feelings, at least on Rhodes' side of things. Speaking to Inside the Ropes, Cody gave a surprising response when asked for his favorite wrestler, saying that WWE COO Triple H reminds him of his father, as they were both capable of doing everything in pro wrestling. "Triple H is probably my favorite wrestler and was a role model. I only watched from a distance, but he reminded me a lot of my dad in the sense that I watched him do all the work, be this executive, and then go out there. He really was a model in terms of, okay, you can do both, but you have to be really disciplined. You have to take it really seriously." Cody may have a ton of respect for the game, but he hasn't shied away from taking shots at the WWE COO, infamously destroying a Triple H throne during the first Double or Nothing pay-per-view. When asked if the game ever got back to him about that infamous throne spot, Cody responded, "No, he did not. He did congratulate me on my baby, and no one knows, because he's got like 100 girls, I think. That was very nice of him." Cody and Triple H might never work together again, but it's nice to know that there's no heat between them, despite AEW's constant jibes at the competition. Earlier this year, Braun Strowman was released from his WWE contract as the company didn't want to keep paying his $1.2 million a year deal. Since then, there's been reports of WWE wanting to bring the former Universal Champion back to keep him from AEW, but Strowman's next destination may not be in pro wrestling at all. Recently, the former WWE superstar was all smiles when he was spotted at a bare-knuckle boxing event, and after posting a selfie, the company teased that Strowman would be their next big signing. For what it's worth, Strowman has been looking at projects outside wrestling, as less than a month before his WWE release, he announced that he'd been training for a bodybuilding competition. Braun has said that waiting on his 90-day non-compete clause has been like jail, and it'll be interesting to see where he goes next when that clause expires on August 31st. Whatever Strowman does next, you may not see it on Instagram, as the content-sharing platform has come down hard on the former Universal Champion. Recently, Strowman shared a photo to his Instagram which showed him kicking Keith Lee in the face on Raw, but that image has now been taken down for violence and incitement by Instagram. An irate Strowman posted about this in his Instagram story, saying that the site was censoring his account and used the hashtag #GetAGrip. It's strange that this photo in particular would be targeted, as Braun has posted plenty of photos and videos of his in-ring work, none of which have been taken down by the site. Whether Braun rejoins WWE, goes to AEW, or bare-knuckle boxing remains to be seen, but odds are he'll think twice the next time he shares on Instagram. One man who knows about sharing the ring with Braun is Brock Lesnar, who hasn't been seen in WWE since his WrestleMania 36 loss to Drew McIntyre. Recently, the Beast emerged with a beard and a Viking ponytail, and he's now been spotted again with another shocking new look. This past weekend, Lesnar was seen out at TC Summer Jam, and a radio personality by the name of Dubs snapped a selfie with Brock wearing a cowboy hat. We wouldn't be surprised if Cowboy Brock becomes a meme, as fans are already having fun with it, and at least Lesnar is enjoying his time away from the ring. For the past week, plenty of stories have come out about CM Punk, who has reportedly signed a deal with AEW. Punk is expected to make his debut at September 5th's All Out pay-per-view in Chicago, Illinois, but nothing has been confirmed by Punk or AEW themselves. With that said, Punk has clearly read the reports of his impending debut, and he's having some fun on social media. On Twitter, Punk has started following the official AEW account, and now also follows both Tony Khan and Vince McMahon. In addition to Punk, Daniel Bryan is set to join AEW soon and will reportedly debut at their Grand Slam Dynamite on September 22nd. And whilst Punk won't be able to tease his debut for long, he's going to have fun while he can. Back to WWE, and Nikki A.S.H. has been on a roll as of late, winning the Women's Money in the Bank briefcase and the Raw Women's title earlier this month. A.S.H. will have no shortage of challengers as the new Raw Women's Champion, and with reports that Becky Lynch is returning soon, we may see Scotland vs. Ireland in a WWE ring. Speaking to the Sunday Post, Nikki teased a match with Lynch, saying she's ready for a challenge from the man, and credited Lynch, alongside Drew McIntyre, as an inspiration that anyone from the UK can become a WWE champion with the right work ethic. Lynch hasn't been on WWE TV since she forfeited the Raw Women's title to Asuka in May 2020 due to her pregnancy, and gave birth to her daughter Rue last December. In the ring, Lynch holds two wins over A.S.H., having defeated her on the November 6, 2018 SmackDown and the July 29, 2019 Raw, but that hasn't deterred WWE's resident superhero from wanting another shot at the man. And we're ending with Eddie Guerrero, who tragically died at the age of 38 after a heart attack ended his wrestling career and life in November 2005. Inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame the next year, Eddie is regarded as one of the greatest 21st century wrestlers, but not everyone feels that way. On Twitter, one user known as Oli branded Eddie a B-plus player at best, adding that people only hold him in such high regard because he's dead. This caused a torrent of responses, with fans defending Guerrero as one of the greatest, and even Mick Foley chimed in, calling Latino Heat an A-plus player. Eddie's nephew Chavo, who recently debuted for AEW, called the original poster a never was and thanked the fans for coming to the defense of his late uncle. Eddie's name was even briefly the number one trend in the United States because of this comment and wave of support, as 16 years later, Latino Heat's fire still burns in the hearts of fans.